This week on the Xtreme Crappie Angler, fishing for slabs during a severe springtime cold front with my buddy Seabass.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Look at that. Swing. Oh yeah.
Hey folks.
Look at that. And again, same story. Yeah.
Then Mr. Crappie introduces the Joker.
Those little tantalizing balls on the end when you jig it, I like to fish this on a 10-foot jig pole, get up in those bushes, weeds.
And colors for crappie.
Nice one. Look at this guy. That one's gonna need to be netted.
I'm Karl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way, visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. The Xtreme Crappie Angler is presented by B&M Poles, leader in crappie, Strike King Lure Company, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor.
Crappie fishing, you feel like you're a kid again, man, I tell you. Even the bluegills.
Yeah.
You feel like a kid again. They're such a perfect fish, man. It tastes great, so plentiful.
They're a lot
and
of
they
work.
Even bite in the wind!
Oh yeah, not just any wind.
No, a nice cold north wind.
Yeah, this feels like October. You think that one hit it?
I love when you move the bait slowly. Yeah, the rods are so sensitive, you feel that. Doom. Incredible.
And it's amazing how long they follow it, too.
Yes. Like that. Yeah. Wow, man. That's a crappie, dude.
That's a crappie?
And I think it's a good one, too.
It's coming towards you.
Oh, yeah. Look at this.
That's a nice one.
Nice one. I think I'll scoop him. Oh, yeah.
You got him?
Oh, he's got a black one. Look at him. He's got some colors on him. Wow. Look at the scar on that thing. That one, you're right, you let it.
Yeah.
I just moved the float and I felt a few pops. A few pops. Now, eater?
Yeah.
Or releaser?
Eater.
All right. 7'2". Sam Super Sensitive by B&M. And we got it with a 6-pound test, monofilament, and fluorocarbon. Little 1/8-ounce sausage head, pro reel, and just making those longer casts, covering the flat. Nice guides, super sensitive. You can just feel those little bites, lead the fish sometimes. Sometimes you don't even see the float move, and you just feel that bite down about 6 feet of water. Real impressive.
Oh, there we go. There's a nice crappie, yeah.
Is it? A netter?
Oh, that's a nice one.
Oh boy, it is a good one, dude. Oh, good boy.
There's a nice.
Oh boy, Seabass. Took us a while to find the fish.
But once you find them, right there, right out of the clumps.
Oh boy.
Beautiful fish.
Cold front cure, huh?
Oh yeah.
Put them in the box, dude.
That's right. Perfect eater.
Okay, now we found these fish here. 7 feet of water. I got the 10-foot poles, so I'm gonna put those down. We're gonna stay right on this little weed bed, on the edge of it here. I'm getting bit right here as I do this. And hopefully we'll stick right on the spot and fish right in this weed bed, dissect it, and hope we find them big ones. Is that a crappie?
Is that a crappie, buddy?
Oh yeah, good one.
Oh yeah.
Whoa, nice crappie. Look where he took it too. Look where he took it. Just phenomenal. That jig head sticking out. That hook is exactly where you want it to be. The top of that yap, in the meat. That's a good eater, isn't it?
That's a beautiful
eater. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Wow. Such a clean, beautiful looking fish. Look at the pearl iridescence on the top here. Just gorgeous, man. Perfect looking fish. Look at, no eggs in them. We're getting them males out here. Let's put them in the box. Oh boy, both floats in the same area most.
There we go, instant. He's not gonna be that big.
Yes, yes.
Nice gill.
Oh my God, dude. Look at this.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Swinger?
You're gonna have to do it.
I don't know, man. I don't know. See?
Oh yeah. awesome.
I love them crappie, boy. With the achievement of figuring out AC bass.
Oh, that's the way you got to do it.
That's how it is. That's another good eater, huh?
That's perfect.
Show the camera. Put it right up close to them. Show them exactly what they're missing.
Look at that. Beauty.
Beautiful crappie, no matter where it is, eh, dudes?
Oh, yeah.
But see how crucial? There's the float. There's the bait. That's almost, oh, I don't know, almost 6 feet. And we're fishing in about, right now, 7.6. Those weeds come up to about 3 feet to about 6-7 back and forth. Those fish are just right on that thing, and that just drifts through, pendulum through with a little bit of wind. 1/8 ounce jig heads, goes right through, right past their face, and you see what happens. They eat it. Let's keep going. Okay, here's the thing. You're fishing a big flat like this. We first came in here, we made a mark here, 477. Now see the weeds like this? We drift into 5 feet, 5.5, 6 feet, nothing. Come out to that 6.6, 7.5. There's the weeds, definitely there's the waypoints. You can see how we've been moving around, and that's where those crappie are. See the weed edges? That's weed right there. Those fish are sitting right in the weed. And the little baits like this, I got the Shadalicious on the little sausage head, black and chartreuse. That drifts through there with a little bit of wave action. It's irresistible. They just grab it. But the key is staying on that spot. You got a big flat like this. You get pushed off with the wind. You wonder where you are. The waypoints will bring you back to the spots you caught the fish.
There we go. That's going to be a crappie, guys.
Oh, yeah.
That's a nice one.
You let me know when you ever need it, if you need the net.
I'm just so getting good at swinging. That's a nice crappie. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yee-haw!
There
Nothing
you go.
Like figuring it out, eh, sea bass?
Oh, yeah. And then getting stationary, and boom.
Yep.
Beautiful.
If this is a crappie, we're in big trouble. It is, dude.
You got a nice one? Or is he just a fighter?
No, it's a big crappie, look.
Oh, look at the flash.
Yep.
Here, I got the net. Oh, yeah.
It's a good eater, right?
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Nice one. Definitely shad pole, sausage head, Shadalicious, but the color is in the deal, eh?
That's right.
Black chartreuse. Good eater. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
Seriously, first thing in the morning, sea bass is out here for 2 weeks fishing all kinds of stuff from this weed bed, the shallows, you name it, back and forth. But last week was nice and warm. You know the old story. Should have been here last week, right?
Yeah,
next week will probably be warm again. But I mean, we were persistent, went back in and tried to get those shallow fish. 2 hours, little spots here and there, forget it. You know what? You're going to keep at it being stubborn. You're not going to catch. You decide to come out here because it's just out from the spawning areas where they are. And look at how many fish are in these weeds and stuff. It's phenomenal. Although the wind is a little unfavorable, we're dressed for it, prepared, and we're having fun.
That's right.
Let's go get some more, buddy.
Oh, there we go.
What?
And if this is a crappie, it's going to be a nicer
it is.
One. Oh, that's
it
a nicer.
Is,
that's a nice one.
Oh.
You got the net, Carl?
Hold on. Oh, yes.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Right on.
That's a slab.
Oh, yeah. Let me just get his... And he, again, I'm just swimming wow. that. Look at that.
Oh, yeah, dude. Beautiful, beautiful.
Awesome. Hook top of the mouth. Hungry? I guess so. Awesome.
Look at that thing, eh? Beautiful.
But thick.
I think it's a male, too.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Great.
There you go, man. Okay, here's three of the baits that in this cold front cure have produced some crappie for us. The chartreuse definitely is the key. Sebastian's getting some really good fish with the black and chartreuse. Like that little June bug in the little Slabalicious with the little flappy tail and that wind up and down, up and down. Shadpole, same thing. This one's got that little purple, like purple haze, but it's got the chartreuse blended inside it. Pretty cool. Again, see a common denominator? And what is that? A little bit of motion from the wind and the float drives those crappy nuts. And last but not least, today, it ain't no joke. Because the joker is catching them up and down, three little legs like that. Sometimes they're actually knocking on the float, they're so aggressive. But they're sitting in the weed, above the weed, and the water column with that heat, they're just right there. So a little bit of chartreuse, a little bit of variety, but we're catching some crappie.
Oh yeah, it's a real good one, I think, dude. Let's see.
Oh yeah, I see the flash.
Oh yeah, it's a netter. Bring it up, Carl.
Oh yeah. There you go.
They're just decent, huh?
Oh yeah. Chunky.
Where's that? I could have lifted him. I just got all nervous because I haven't caught one in a while, you know? Like it all like all shaky and stuff. When I get nervous, I just go like this. It's so cool, man. You know what? We went through about 45 minutes with Squatolo and then moved around, poles up, move around, go around, nothing. 45 minutes moving around. All of a sudden, whoop, one tells you, one good one. Got some small ones, don't care. One good one tells you, put the poles down and search them out, then destroy them. And put them in a box. Come on, boy.
Hey, do you know anything about cornmeal? You know anything about fried crappie? We're talking southern fried peanut oil, the whole deal. But to get the crappie, you can't buy it at the store. We're talking about you got to get the Joker by Mr. Crappie and Strike King. I designed this bait a couple years ago. I'm telling you, the Joker is the real deal. Those little tantalizing balls on the end when you jig it, I like to fish this on a 10-foot jig pole, get up in those bushes, weeds, any kind of visual structure. That's what I look for in the springtime, visual structure around the shoreline when the water temperature is about 60 degrees or above. Those big black crappie and white crappie love the Joker. Comes in about 16 different colors. You got to try it. The 2-inch Mr. Crappie Joker by Strike King.
It doesn't matter, cold front or not. You're dressed properly, you're prepared. That's what it's all about, really. You know what? I packed all my shorts and t-shirts and stuff from the first day we got here, had some fun. I was wearing those. But all of a sudden, the temperature goes down to one, minus one. It feels like minus three. If you're not prepared, you're sitting back at the cottage. Not us. This is extreme, baby. So,
oh yeah,
I better get the net.
I'm gonna swing him in, but he's nice.
Oh, nice one, dude.
Right there.
Oh boy. Right on cue. Way to go, man. Way to go.
Look at all the bigger fish. Look how deep they got that. That shows you how aggressive they are. They just nailing it.
He missed your bait, but he's seen your float.
Did you see the size of that crappie?
I know. Don't worry, I'm casting right there.
Oh my God, dude. I think I got him, dude.
You think you got him?
Oh yeah, net, man, net. Pretty sure this is the one that hit my
flopper. Yeah. Oh, look at that. Right on, Carl.
What does Josh Donaldson say? Let it rain, baby, let it rain. No, bring the rain. Woo, I loved him, crappie. Wow, I'm pretty sure this guy was so aggressive. He slammed my float. I know that's not the biggest black crappie you've ever seen in your life, but boy, oh boy, when you're getting them like this on a day where you thought,
hold on,
maybe not, look at this, look at this. It's just psychotic, man.
Yeah, there's another one.
I can't tell you how much fun it is when you slowly just figure it out and stuff, because sometimes failure is not an option. You got to find out ways, presentations, baits, speeds, water temperature, wherever it is, wherever those fish are in the water column, you got to figure out a way to catch them and have some more fun. And we've done that today. It's been amazing. Oh no, I got a real good one, I think. Oh yeah, whoa. Look at this. Wow. Well, you never like to say saranara. And ain't one of our bigger fish of the day, but it's a nice crappie. We'll let him go. But next time you go out for crappie and you get them in the shallows, Mother Nature throws a curveball, wind, north wind, yeah, by the way, and heavy and cold temperatures, move out. Come out to the first edges, because those crappie do not go far. They want to do their business up in there pretty soon.
So they're going to be close to where they want to do their stuff. Find the weed, rock, edges, something that they can relate to, and you're going to catch them too.
Closed captioning of this program presented by Sportsman Protein Shake.
What is it about color for crappie? I mean, there's so many colors on the rainbow from A to Z, and so many anglers say that, try this pink with this, this black and chartreuse, this red and white tube, this grub, whatever. It's all angler preference. And for me, it's something that when I'm fishing for crappie, and all I want them to do is see it. There we go. Big black one, came out of the tree. Look at him. Big blackie came out of the tree. Oh boy. How's that? Look how dark. Ooh lordy. Single poling. Black and purple. Look at that. He's got some spawning colors on there. Tuxedo. Let him go. Look at that, all nice and purple and black. Just a beautiful looking fish, huh? Beautiful. Let's put them back here. Something with chartreuses, chartreuse black, chartreuse with a little bit of purple on top, chartreuse white. Then I go to the pinks, pink and black, pink and chartreuse. It doesn't matter. Nope, look all black. You know what they're trying to do. Look at that. Typical spawning colors. Look at him. He's got those beautiful tuxedos on. He's all dark, but he got it right through the bottom there. Look at him. We talk about a spawning crappie. Look at the colors on that fish. Amazing. You know where he's hiding too, in that tree. Let's put him back and see if we can find one of the ones that potentially he's spawning with. Ready, boy? Ready? Whoa, there he goes. But see? Outrageous colors. You say to yourself, you gotta be a crappie fisherman to wear stuff like this. And I am. But using different tones, the chartreuse black, pink and purple, pink and white, red and white, orange and chartreuse, you name it. It boggles the mind. But anything that gives me confidence, gives you confidence for crappie, tie it on, fish it, and catch. Oh yeah, there's one there, big one too. Look at this one. All dark. Look at him. Wow. Is he dark or what? Hey? Look at that crappie. Wow. Look where he's got that. Contrasting all his dark colors. He got that right down. Whew. He wanted that bright pink, black, and chartreuse. Slab slanger. Messed up. And let him go, he's a beautiful looking fish. Ready, crappie? Ready? Go on, boy. Some of my favorite colors. Slab slanger, you know, the black with chartreuse, obviously. Pumpkin chartreuse, again, offset, little natural tones, bright chartreuse. Electric chicken, pink with chartreuse. I love that stuff, man. And natural greens. You got your white, refrigerator whites, chartreuse. Purple and black, blue glimmer, and of course, clear, little white. Good, good fish. Look at that. Look how black. Look how cool that looks. Hey? I love them when they're black and mean like that. Black and mean and crappie. Hiding in the trees. Look at all black belly. Ooh, black belly. Ooh, la loo. Nom, 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 nom. Let's let them go. Go on. Go back to your business. Something that offsets a natural tone, let's say, white. Every fish under the belly is white. But when you mix the reds, greens, blues, just abstract things. You know, crappie are really crazy. As long as you get their attention, they'll come out, whoa, boom, and eat it. Or when you're single poling, you put it into locations where they are, they see it again, you're putting it into their kitchen, boom, you're gonna get smacked. So for me, when it comes to color and crappie, it's all about picking things that gives me confidence, because I know I'm gonna put those baits in the right places, or I'm gonna use this, the right cadence or presentation to get bit. So it's about confidence. Find the locations, find where those crappie are, then having a bait, like the Striking Mr. Crappie, with a shad pole, a sausage head, it doesn't matter what it is, something that they see, gets a reaction, and gets them to bite it. Oh, big one. Nice one. Look at this guy. That one's gonna need to be netted. Oh, look at him fight, look at him fight. Hey. Oh, Lordy. There's a nice crappie right there, boy. Am I crazy for crappie? I am. Best you in there that big. Look at that. Wow. And that little bait, Mr. Crappie, slab slanger. The little tail, I barely move it. And I got on a bright pink head. Look at all the contrasting colors there. Pink, black, chartreuse. You think it's outrageous. It's crazy. Outlandish. Nothing's gonna eat it. Nothing but crappie. You going in the box, boy. Love it.
The Xtreme Crappie Angler is presented by B&M Poles, leader in crappie. Strike King Lure Company, Power Pole Shallow Water Anchor. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.